Prime Minister Modi has held a meeting with Union Home Minister Amit Shah and National Security Advisor Ajit Doval and others after a probe indicated that a group of terrorists killed in Jammu and Kashmir a day before were planning something big ahead of the local elections in the Union Territory. Prime Minister Modi, in fact, tweeted that our security forces have once again displayed utmost bravery and professionalism. Thanks to their alertness, they have defeated a nefarious plot to target grassroots level democratic exercises in Jammu and Kashmir. Let's go across to Neeta Sharma and Nazeer Masoodi joining me now. Neeta, tell us what happened in this meeting and a big terror attack foiled by the security forces.
Yes, it was a big victory, Rohit, and that's why, you know, and the stakes are also very high for Bharatiya Janata Party as far as the DVC elections are concerned. So, you know, these are the first elections which are going to be held in Jammu and Kashmir after special status of Jammu and Kashmir was done away with. So they are very important. But as far as this meeting was concerned, the Prime Minister himself chaired the meeting. The Union Home Minister, Mr. Amit Shah, was there. The National Security Advisor, Ajit Doval, briefed all of them. All top intelligence officials were also there participating in this meeting. They gave input as to from where these terrorists, you know, infiltrated. These heavily armed terrorists, you know, in fact, had infiltrated to India from Samba sector and they were on their way to Kashmir, where they were planning to do something big. That can also be judged by the fact that they were very heavily armed. They, in fact, were carrying 11 AK-47s, 3 pistols and 29 grenades. The Prime Minister was also briefed as to what kind of security arrangements are being made for the forthcoming DDC elections, which are going to start from November 28th in eight phases. These elections are going to be held. So the Prime Minister was briefed by all top intelligence agency officials regarding all the preparations also and what kind of an attack the Pakistan was trying to do. And, you know, even recently, in recent weeks and days, we have seen Pakistan has done lot many ceasefire violations also. Lot many infiltration attempts have been made by them. So continuous inputs which are being received by the intelligence agencies were shared with the Prime Minister. Go ahead.
All right, Neeta, thanks very much for joining us with those details. Let's go across to Nazeer Masoodi. Nazeer, this indeed is the alertness of the security forces that such a big terror attack was foiled. Give us the sense of these elections that are being held there amid heavy security, of course.
Well, the meeting chaired by Prime Minister, attended by National Security Advisor, Home Minister Mr. Amit Shah, shows how significant local elections have become in Jammu and Kashmir. The leadership at the highest level is taking cognizance, is holding meetings about the conduct of these elections and the possible this terror attack, what Prime Minister now also talked about. Yesterday morning, four militants were killed in Nagrota near Jammu. They were traveling in a truck and 11 rifles were recovered from that truck as well. They are believed to have infiltrated from Samba sector and looks, you know, it is just not possible for just four to, you know, get 11 rifles. So that means it was a large cache of arms and ammunition were being smuggled into Kashmir. And police are saying it was meant to disrupt and carry out an attack ahead of this district development council and panchayat elections in Jammu and Kashmir. These elections have already become controversial in a sense. Opposition is alleging that their candidates have been confined into security enclosures while BJP candidates are being allowed to campaign. That is what opposition is alleging, but the police are saying, look, they are allowing everybody, but some people have been kept in security zones because of the security concerns. But given the fact Prime Minister himself, you know, chairing a meeting about these elections and this attack, which was to, disrupt these or carry out these elections, it shows how significant local elections post-abrogation of 370 has become. And there's the alliance called People's Alliance, which has all the major regional parties in it. They're all against the BJP and also the local party called Apni Party, which is known as King's Party as well. So interesting time here. But we see shadow of militancy or the terror already there. Prime Minister now personally talking about it, and yesterday's encounter is clearly now linked to the major attack to disrupt these polls in Jammu and Kashmir. The first phase of elections will be held on 28th of this month, and there would be eight phase election, district development council elections. 280 candidates will be, members will be selected from 20 districts across Jammu and Kashmir. very interesting. You know, at the besides this, there are around more than 12,000 panchayat members who will also be elected during this electoral process, which will continue for more than 1 month.